Yeah.
Tonight we're going to learn about the inyan of a mechitza and a shul. What's the makor having a mechitza and a shul? Start off with a Mishnah, Maseches Sukkah. Mishnah, Perek Hei, Mishnah Beis.
Is this a good mechitza called?
We're going to see by the shir.
You told me last time.
You should have some. Put this underneath. Mishnah Beis. In the middle of the page, you have the Mishnah, Aleph Beis, the Mitzoy Yontif Arishin Shel Chag. The Mitzoy Yontif of the first day of Sukkis. In Eretz Yisrael is one day Yontif. The Mitzoy first day Sukkis was Simchas Beis HaSheva. Yardu Le'ezes Nashim. They went down to the Ezes Nashim. U'mesak N'sham Tikkun Gadol. And they would make a Tikkun Gadol. And the Mishnah continues on to discuss the preparation for the Simchas Beis HaShu'eva, which occurred the second night of Sukkot. Now the Mishnah here says, Masak Nisham Tikkun Gadol, they would go down to the spot that was called the Ezes Nashim, the Beis HaMikdash. There was an area called the Ezes Nashim, the Ezes Yisrael, and the Ezes Kohen. What would they do in the Ezes Nashim? Masak Nisham Tikkun Gadol, they make a Tikkun Gadol.
A bigger area?
What does it mean, this Tikkun Gadol? So let's take a look at the Gemara. Let's turn to the Gemara. It's the third page. Daflon Aleph Amid Beis, the Gemara on the bottom. Seven lines from the bottom of the page. The Gemara says, My Tikkun Gadol, Mimitzoy Yomtifs, that's the Mishnah. My Tikkun Gadol, what is this Tikkun Gadol? Amar Belazer Keoisus Shoshaninu. This Tikkun Gadol is like we learned in the Maseches Midas that the Ezes Nashim Chalaka Hoisa was smooth, but he shined originally. The Kifur Gzustra, and they surrounded it with a porch. The Skinu and the Masakin Shu Nashim Yoishas Ramayla. Nashim should sit on the top, on the porch. Va'an Nashim Amata men down. That's how Rebbe Lazar explains the Mishnah. The Gemara now brings a bright and discusses what was the historical, what happened originally. Originally they had a different tikkun that they did. Until they came to this tikkun gadol, there were some other tikkunim, but they didn't work. Till we came to the stage where they made a tikkun gadol that they put around a gzustra, a sort of like a porch around Azar, where the woman can look down from above.
When they say tikkun, you mean the fixing? That's
yeah. Tikkun Gadol means like
a great remedy
for Klal Yisrael, something to help out.
Not learning something in the tikkun. The tikkun a klali,
rest.
All year round. No.
Yeah. What does it mean?
They didn't have many ladies in the Beis HaMikdash.
Well, not necessarily. I mean, like even today you see that the Kotel, I'm not talking about these crazy women, I'm talking about these silly Kotel, that women were comfortable with the Indian.
Wasn't common for women. There wasn't a place of tefillah. There was karban. Women would privately come to bring a karban, but it wasn't a Tana Rabbanan. The Braisa said, "Bishayna yinashim bifnim." In the beginning, they were all on the same level. There was no porch. The women were inside the Azara, the Ezes Nashim. But Anashim Achutz, the men were outside on the Harabais. They were not in the Beis HaMikdash. And that's where they would celebrate Simchas Beis HaSheva.
Segregated. Are we talking about
Roish? They had separate areas. Vayubayim the Kalis Roish, however, they would still come to lightheadedness. There would be an issue of Kalis Roish. Between the men and the women. The women should be outside, in the Harabayis. The men inside. Maybe that would be better. However, there would still be issues of Kalas Reish. Therefore, we came to the final takana. The Braith explains, the Noshim should be situated on the top. Now the Gemara asks, so that is what the Mishnah meant, Omasakisham Tikkun Gadol. that they would build this porch there on Matzah Yomtiv so the women could come in and they can have Simchas Beit HaSheva. That was a Tikkun Gadol. Gemara asks, Hey Chidami, Hey Chavid Hachi, how are they allowed to do this? Baksiv, the Pasuk says, Vakoil Biksav Miyad Hashem Alai Hitzkul. David HaMelech told Shlomo, the blueprints for the Beis HaMikdash are exact. They were all told to me by the Nevi'im. You have no right to make any changes to these blueprints, how you're going to build the Beis HaMikdash. Hakol Biksav, all this that is written, Miyad Hashem Alai Hitzkul, came to me from Hashem. Yeah. So how are they allowed to make any changes? Like Rashi says, Kol Maleches HaTavnis, the entire blueprints of the Mishka on the last line of the page, Shehidiyah HaKadosh Baruch Hu HaYidei God HaChoyzev V'Nasa HaNavi, Nevi'im instructed David how to build the Beis HaMikdash. So how are they allowed to come and add in additions?
One second, the men have to dance, right? So they need room to dance. The woman doesn't dance, you go to the Simcha Beit HaSheva. You go to Crown Heights. See how the dancing and...
So that's why originally put the men outside, because it's there's more space.
Boom.
And the Harabayas all around. Didn't work out, they put the men inside, and it still was an issue. Amar Rav said, Kra Ashkechu V'Darash. They found a pasuk in the Torah, and they were derish from this pasuk. They expounded that since we see in this pasuk, there's a necessity for mechitza. So therefore, they said this is embedded in the Torah itself, the concept of mechitza. Therefore, this is not something that's going against anything of the Torah. It's okay what we're doing. The safta, it says in Zechariah, the safta ha'aretz mishpachis levat. At the time when Mashiach will come, there will be, before Mashiach will come, or when Mashiach will come, is Machlokes in the Gemara, there's going to be a great eulogy, a great hesped. V'saf ta'aretz, the land is going to eulogize mishpach, each family is for themselves. And the Pasuk explains, Mishpach is based up in Levad, the family based up in it for itself, u'nishayim Levad, and their women themselves. The women themselves and David based David themselves. Now, Rashi explains that's the Nevuah of Zechariah that he was saying, you know, before Mashiach comes, the going to Mulchamas Goy Gomaga. In that Mulchama, Mashiach ben Yosef. There's Mashiach ben Yosef, Mashiach ben David. Mashiach ben Yosef, Mashiach who comes from the seed of Yosef, is going to be killed in the Mechamat Goy Gomaga.
40 years.
And then there's going to be a big hesped on the Mashiach and Yosef's, on the fact that he was killed. So we see that they separated the two. There was Beis David on its own, had a hesped, and the Nesheim had a hesped. Amru, so they said like this, they expounded the pasuk. Va'aloi dvarim kal v'choymer. Are not these things a kal v'choymer? There's two reasons why you should not need a mechitza. Number one, they're dealing with hesped. People at the time of mourning, it's not a time of kalas reish. So why should we be choshish for kalas reish? It's a sad time. Another reason, there's no yitzahara because the Mashiach will come. It says that Hashem's going to take away the Yetzirah. Amr HaTorah, still all the Torah says, Anoshim Levad, V'noshim Levad, that you should be separate. Achshav Shasukim B'Simcha, now that they're having a Simcha, if Simcha is Beis HaSheva, the Yetzirah Shoylet B'Hem, Yetzirah's rules over them, Halachas V'Kam V'Kam. The Gemara asks now side questions. The Gemara asks, what was this whole Hesped about? So one answer is that it was one that said it had to do with Mashiach and Yosef being killed. The other one is that actually it's about the Yitzhahara being killed. Someone said Yitzhahara being killed. Why are they all mourning about the Yitzhahara being killed? That's a Galilean thing. So it says that tzaddikim are going to look at this, are going to see the Yitzhahara strength. See how powerful the Yetzer Hara is. They're going to say, they're going to cry when they remember how were they able to accomplish it? Memorize it, remembering back, how were they able to be so strong over the Yetzer Hara? So it's not about now, it's about their memories of the past. And the Rishayim are now going to see the Yetzer Hara being shechted, and the Yetzer Hara are going to think, what was the big deal really? Now they're coming to the ending of time, realizing the truth, realizing the Yetzer Hara is nothing really. The Yetzer Hara is like a chut hasayir, it's just like he hears breath. Yeah. And why didn't we control ourselves? So the Rishayim are all going to be sad. So each one for their own reason is having a hesped. That's what the Gemara says. Another pshat in this nevuah schari over here. The tzaddikim held nidbalahem kehar kavoya. They see how powerful it was. They can't fathom how did they ever manage to do it. And the Rishayim nidlam kuchut asayra. And they were crying, Hey, chaleinu lich beishas chut asayra azah. And it says Hashem agrees with them both. He understands both the tzaddikim's perspective and the Rishayim's perspective. Anyways, Lamaisa, this Gemara in Sukkah was pointed out to be the source for our minig, for the fact that our shuls have a mechitza. Now, let's turn back to the first page. What was the actual function of the mechitza? The Mishnah on the first page. What was the function of the mechitza? Was it that they shouldn't be taroivis? They shouldn't be mingling? Or there shouldn't be re'iyah staklus, people shouldn't be looking at the women. What was the issue? What was the concern of the Chacham?
Both.
Both? So both, or is it only the mingling? Let's take a look.
It's not gemira. That's the whole issue that they had all these shuvot about how hard the mechitza has to be.
Yeah.
If you look, you mingle. If you don't look, you don't mingle.
Let's take a look. The second page.
The Mishnah says it is one issue to Kalos Reish.
The Mishnah, the Gemara says, explains Kalos Reish, right? But we're not really sure what was the Kalos Reish referring to. They're both Kalos Reish. The fact looking at the women and mingling with the women is Kalos Reish. So the second page of Mishnayis, we have right underneath the Mishnah Gimel, we have Pirish and Mishnayis Arambam. Right underneath the Mishnah. We have the first of the Mefarish Pirush and Mishnah. Yeah. Noshim, it says Tikkun Gadol. Says the Rambam explains. Writes a Loimer. The Mishnah is trying to explain. Gadol Hatielis. That there was a. What does Tikkun Gadol mean? It was a great help. It was a great benefit. But what was the benefit? Ki Ama Yimisakinim Makim Lanoshim, Lanoshim, Umakim, Lanoshim. Anashim l'mayla m'makim anashim. Why? They made separate places, anashim higher than anashim. K'day sh'listaku hanashim v'anashim. There's an order that the men should not look at the women. U'shetzayir ha'azara b'chlola. When I will show you a drawing of the azara, yizbar l'cha az hanashim, v'zlosim l'kim, you'll see clearly where is as a stashim. So l'maysa, the Rambam writes clearly is because women shouldn't look, they shouldn't be looking. And in have a stackless.
Women or the men?
The men. Let's take a look back to the first page. We have a Toisus Yomtiv. Pirush of the Toisus Yomtiv. Yomtiv Lipman Heller, the Talmud of the Meral of Prague. I have a chaver, his name is Yomtiv Lipman Heller. He is a grandson, Ben Archeben.
Of the
Pasuk. Yeah, same exact name. Yontif Litman Helm.
I don't want to
He lives in Crown Heights. There's a Rav in Crown Heights, Rav Heller. Yeah, came Lubavitch, the father. The son is a... So the father, son, has an exact name.
Yeah. Wow.
Yontif Litman Heller. Actually, Hey Tammuz, 4 days ago, was a day that the Tosis Yontif. He had a whole story in the Kehila where he lived, where there was one of the Balabatim over there, the Gvirim over there, didn't like the Rav. And he decided that he's going to get to come on the Rav, and he made a Malshinis. the Nebuch slandered the Rav to the government, and he had the Toys Tzionto was actually arrested and put into jail. So imagine the Rav of the Kehila was sitting in jail because one of the Balabatim, the he didn't like what he was saying. So we don't need the Rav; we put him in jail. So the Rav was put in jail. It was on Hay Tammuz he was arrested, and he was later freed on Hay Adar. Next year, Hay Adar, he was freed.
What's the year?
So he wrote. Well, it was a while, yeah. So he wrote 3/4 of a year. So he wrote to. He made that one in his will. He wrote the entire story as a Megillas Eva. It's a short story where he records the entire story, the whole background. I think it's maybe 40 pages. I don't remember the size. The whole story, the background of what happened, the Kehila, and how he was. What happened? What was the background till he was arrested and he was released? The whole story. He left the city.
Apologies.
Yeah, he gave the whole story. But he writes a tzava for his children. All his children and grandchildren have to always commemorate these 2 days. Hey, Tammuz, they have to fast, the day he was arrested. And the day he was released on Hey Adar, they have to make a big suda. So they have all the grandchildren, wherever they are in the world, whether they have the name Heller or whether they don't have the name Heller, they fast. And now, today's days, a lot of them don't fast anymore, but they point to the tainus. They give the worth of the amount of their meals of the day, they give it to tzedakah. But the suda, they make a real suda.
Yeah, I read what the man was one of the, when he's in South Africa, to have a big barbecue before Pesach, one of his children said, we used to give the amateurs. You know, a lot of people from the family that weren't the servant, and they've come and they give them the amateurs.
So they're holding on to
the
something.
They read the
Megillus Eva.
From 1860, it's in English.
1860, it's already in English.
Yeah. This is the one.
What are they called?
Yeah.
What is his family?
His family.
What do they call the Heller? What is his name?
Yeah. In the Sefer, he wrote Toysis Yamtu. His name was Yamtu.
What is this guy? What is the somebody's called?
It is Yamtiv Lipman, they call it.
Lipman.
Now,
by the way, this fellow made the bris for the twins, Alex, the Russian guy, about 2 months ago. This Heller walked from Borough Park to make the
yeah.
Bris. Oh, so the person?
They have the Shuvah, the place can discuss whether or not it applies to the grandchildren, to the children, that people that marry into the family. Place can discussion whether this Tzava, the will, it's a binding. It's binding on the family.
Wow.
It's a binding to those that enter into the family.
Sigi coming in. The newcomer.
Yeah. So Lamaisa, the Tosis Yom Tov says, Tikkun Gadol, the Olam sees the second wide line. Tikkun Gadol, the ending of the second wide line, left column, Tosis Yom Tov, Tikkun Gadol, Ritzayin Elohimer, Gadol Hatayela Saramba. He quotes the Rambam that Tikkun Gadol means that was a great benefit. Because of Harav Bartanura, the Bartanura writes, Shoyi Makifino Yisag Zustra, that they would surround her with a porch. The Gemara brings that Ka'ois Hashaninu, like we learned in the Mishnah Mideis, Chalakois B'Rishoyin, in the beginning, it was smooth the walls, V'Kifu V'Zustra, then they put in this porch. P'Vish Rashi Sh'B'Rishoyin Elohayu Aziz in Yoytzim Aksalim.
What does smooth mean? What does smooth
mean? I mean the wall. There was nothing on the wall. Now they put things protruding from the wall that the women can stand on.
Oh.
A balcony.
Nice
and zizin, the ksalim. They put in pieces into the wall. Boiled them in that koisel sabav, sticking out from the wall all around. Bechol shana, misadisham, zestroim, luchim shakarim plank. It seems that they stuck into the wall permanent pieces that stuck out, but they put planks on top of it when it came with Tzoy Yom to Sukkis. They built platforms on it. They put platforms on these protrusions that were sticking out. Kadesh Yunashim, Bezeo Ochil, Tichum Gadol, Ketanis Hamashana Rashi. So he quotes the Rambam, the Gemara, Rashi.
Here's
the Gemara. The Gemara asks, "Vaksiv Hakob Ksadim Hashem Aloi Hiskel." How are they allowed to add to the base of Mikdash? The Tirit of the Gemara answered, Karash, Kavodarish, they had a pasuk that they expel on the Safta Oretz, Mishpach is based on Levan, Hashem Levan, he's quoting the Gemara, but Kabachoyim and Makam Hesped and Makam Simcha. If a Makam Hesped needed, for sure, Makam Simcha needs. A Masha Kosev, Harav, and Oshem Amayla. This is the Bartuna writes, the women were above. Pidush HaRambam, the Rambam explained, like we saw earlier in the Rambam, it was Kadesh Lestaklu HaNashim HaNashim. The men should not look at the women. But Hadin Imay, and the Rambam is correct with this, that that was the purpose of it. Ki HaNashim Shalomata Hayu HaRoyim B'Simcha. The Nashim that were on the bottom, they were the ones looking at the Simcha. They weren't all dancing. It was only the Hasidim, the Anshei Maisa that danced in the middle. The Choshevi didn't dance. Everyone else came and watched. Lo yasmeichim ba'atzman. The problem was the people down the bottom that were watching the Simcha, they were having Kalos Roish. The Chassidim, Anshei Maisa were busy dancing and they were Chassidim, Anshei Maisa. The problem was the men that came to watch the Simcha. The Shekhar said, Rabbi Midasham, ki yasmeichim ayu Chassidim. The top of the page, top line of the page. That's what the Rambam writes. The reason was that they were looking. What the Gemara explains, kalos roish, it means seeing, because the seeing would bring the kalos roish. Meaning, einachanami, the ultimate issue was the kalos roish. But it started off the fact that there was a staklus. There was a staklus of the man and the woman. There's an issue here. We have already from the klal of chava. Yitzahara. Further he says, even if there wouldn't be an issue of the men and women having a shaychis, even the men themselves, but the ingin of Ihuri Aveira, which could bring an ingin of kishaladas, v'shema yirikeri, these are in the Yonim of Aveira, so therefore a kol shekein b'chatz b'Hashem, v'shur ne b'is ha-mikdash.
Here it doesn't say that he was a mechitza, it just says they were above.
Yeah, ein echanami.
There was no mechitza.
Ein echanami. Lav dafka was there a mechitza.
Wasn't
could be the Micah needed to have a Micah. See some Micah like a gagefa.
Yeah, but that's not
but
hard.
Not
that's
else, not no. But...
That's not proof because it was mechitza.
Good, but this is already a very big thing. Already high up. It was a very high. It was 7.5 amas high. The
so
area.
Then, if you go to concern, let's say they get a wonder. We had the speech over here. They introduced him to the Muncie, the Jewish whatever. They had a business. The Jewish center. They took him for audition. So they liked him. Arosa before he came here 10 years ago. So then they. Then he says, go up on the mechitza. There was no mechitza. But he could have suggested they build something higher.
But that you have a lot of older shuls like that, modern Orthodox shuls that will have a big balcony.
Is that all according to halacha, 100%? According to this, yes.
Well, we'll talk about it soon. We have to, stage one. Stage one is that we know that they were separated, and they were separated higher, which makes it difficult to see already, because we're now, you're expecting men to look all the way up. It's a very different situation.
Well, it might have been really high.
It was 7.5 amas high.
That's
which, depending on the cheshbon of an amma, you know,
it's not so high.
How do you
know
there's 7.5 amas high? The cheshbon is how high the balcony, the Azara was.
So no,
I didn't look into that detail.
It could be 100% kosher.
About a foot and a half, foot and a quarter.
I'll tell you an example. By Neiris Chanukah, it says you're not allowed to put it higher than 20 amas, right? Why? Because the eye doesn't see high. Eye what? Of course people could see. But the point of the matter is, where is people's view? So over here, we're not giving a sheer 20 amas, but when something's higher up, it's not as an issue when people are on the same level. It's higher up. If people are davening, they're looking, they have to go look up. It's not, people are not going to be like this the whole time, you know? We hope not.
According to this, it's a perfectly legitimate thing.
Hey, Amen. We didn't finish a shir yet. We read a Mishnah and a Gemara. You have to come to the ending of the shir. Now, there's a tshuva of the Maharam Sheikh. Ramesh Sheikh was a Talmud of the Chassam Sofer. there was an issue in that time where people were trying to make a lot of changes in Hungary, bringing down the standards. Hine, in the first middle of the first line, Hine mashat the shoyl. This that you're asking, Shepritze ha'am ha'shebekal pleini, in a certain community, there are people that are trying to break the standards. Adata hoyu chaneseyem segunim v'shabbos koydish. Till now their stores were closed on Shabbos. And now they're making a game. They said, the ata ezer v'shoyim sholchu yad ladis v'zis nashim. They came to the shul, and they destroyed the davar ha'mafsi v'zis nashim anashim. They destroyed the wall that was between the Ezes Noshim and Anoshim. Shaloite Sagra Lagami Bakrashim. It shouldn't be totally closed off. Rak Bamudim, it should just be pillars with spaces in between.
He doesn't hold it.
Veyuchlu Lires, that people can see and they can show themselves. Verabim Oimim. Many people say, Hashem Hashemba Ezra Shemiz Babiyat Hazak Uchaluch. Many people are telling me, says the Rav. The Ramar Shik is quoting the Shiloh. Many people are saying that if you're going to be strong, you're going to be able to win and make the mechitza, keep the mechitza. The Roshoyim are saying, if you don't allow us to make these changes, we are going to leave the community. They threatened, we're going to open up our stores on Shabbos. The Yepesuach Ach B'Shabbos. Mitoich Kach Nekel Adover Shegam Achei Michal Shabbos Kodesh. And if they're going to open up, these people, obviously then other people are going to see this and are going to bring a general pritza in the whole concept of Shabbos Kodesh. If you don't know, what to do? If you're going to fight them and hold strong and not allow them to make this change in the shul, they'll go lazazel, go with the shita that let the Russia. Either Russia's going to go open up shuls on Shabbos, it's not our responsibility. We have to stand strong and keep the shul the way it is. Or no. Maybe other people are going to be chapped into their group and they're going to start another kehila and they're going to open up the shuls. It's going to become a worse calamity. It was a catch-22 over here. Therefore you feel maybe it's better to be quiet. Let it pass, this thing that they're doing, that they're just making a mechitza with just pillars. They're going to sit separately. They're going to sit separate seating.
Tradition.
They're going to have separate seating, but they're going to have pillars, as they pillars, every foot or two have a pillar. And so it will be, generally we're separated. There is some sort of mechitza, but they can see, it's open to see. So the Maisa answers, Ba'at ka l'shoyin cha. Hine, the Ramshik was from the very strong Hungarian Rabbanim. And he wrote, Hine, Chalil Olochem Lachshiram, Chas V'Shalom, to allow them to do it, Lishtek, to be quiet. Al Dvar HaPritzah She'otzah, Chatzufim Heidis Chutz Peniaks. Ki Medina on a Mechiyam, you have no choice. You have Allah in Torah, you have to make a Mecha. Min Mechiyam Olas, is have some as Nosh as Nosh. You have to make a Mechitza, just like Meishoy Beis HaMikdash. As is Nosh in Lechot. Es ist einer schon bekommen. Wo ist denn ja, wenn man schon hier ist, wenn man schon ein Wasser schon tücken geht? Kies und man sagt, es sucke, perka, cholil, but after all, what we just read. Wie schön viel, schon mit Kroh, wie lernen einfach mal Passig, zurück lass es tücken, schon lo jiru, einer schon mal einer schon. Wie bin ich schon mehr mit dir, kann es reich? Bescheid auf es. Und other ways, ein schon, Tessian, explains, not only kann es reich, kies, lo das, carry, והפורץ עם אורים גם כמו שבסעס לפי שם הלכיכם. There's another affair they're doing the Taibus in the Beis HaMikdash in the Beis HaKnesset גם כמו מקדש מעט. קיצר חיובים למחיס על זה ולכיכם לא עבר עבר. יהיה בחיב תימויכם, that's it. למעשה, what I want to bring out from all that we read above, from a lot of what we read above, from the Ram Pirush Mishnayis al Rambam, the Toisus Yomtiv, the Chosman Amshik, it seems that the time for why Mechitza was built was the issue of sin. Came along in our generation, Moshe Feinstein, and because there were many, many issues between in the early years here in America, where there were shuls that were, people were pulling, they're on the verge of going to conservative, it was always on the line, conservative, orthodox, and the mechitza was the big call. So the Moshe went into the whole sugya and came up with a chiddush, anu mahalach. But the Moshe felt that there is room to make all to a certain extent. And this is based on the fact that he felt that the reason for why Chazal made this tikkun gadol in the Beis HaMikdosh was not for staklus, because of sin, because they were concerned about taroivis mingling. The kalus roish was the mingling. The taruvis that was going to be brought out, the mingling. Based on this chiddush, because the Moshe held this way, therefore he felt the mechitza does not have, only has to make sure there's no mingling.
Turn this off.
No.
That was something else.
See in a second. When Moshe held that the issue is taroivis, and therefore, as long as it's high enough that they can't mingle, it's not an issue. Therefore, he said, as long as it's up to the shoulders, up to the shoulders. If it's lower, people can pass something. You can give a handshake. You can give a hug. Something can happen over there, mingling. So you make it up to the shoulder height. People's heads are still above, they can see. That's not why Chazal made it.
Who brought up the stock?
So therefore, light room, Moshe, you can have the mechisa up to the height, it can even be see-through. It can even be see-through, it can be made out of glass, like the Moshe.
Rabbi, 25 years ago, Rabbi Mordechai Eliyahu came here, Zechat Tzadik Livracha, who was praying in Bet Torah. They have mechisa like this. He gave it to Russia, he said it's no good, you have to hire it. The higher thing, glass. You can see through, but much higher, double.
Yeah. This goes into the Moshe's Mahalach.
That's the Moshe, yeah.
Now, I want to take this tshuva was written in 1946 to one of the Rosh Hashiva in Tervah Das. There's a lot of tshuvas in the Moshe about Mechitza, tons and tons of tshuvas. We're just going to look at the first original tshuva where he bases his shita.
Really?
And there have been a lot of ink has been spilled on this tshuva of Moshe. Many rabbanim arguing with him, some trying to, some agreeing with him. A lot of people. We are holding Moshe. It's number.
So the Mishnah and the Gemara doesn't say the word.
Six.
It doesn't say the word.
Page
stop.
Six in the book. The page Tzadik Ches. Yeah.
Doesn't say the word is stock.
The Gemara itself does not say Kalas Roish.
It says Kalas Roish. So now the question is, what generates the Kalas Roish?
Right.
Is it a stock?
So the Rambam, the Pirush Mishnah, is the Rambam, and the Tosis Yom to mention the stock. The Tshuvas Maram Shika Tamlach Sam Soifer, coming closer down the line, said the stockless. Either having Amudim, these Amudim pillars that are separating, that's not enough. Liris to Laharis. The men want to look, and the women want laharis. So it's an issue over here. So you got to stand up strong, and even though they're threatening Chilul Shabbos, you have no heter. He couldn't find any heter. The Maram Shik. They came along Rav Moshe in 1946, and Rav Moshe said, "I can find the heter." And Rav Moshe had a pupil. Let's take a look inside.
Well, we put another rishon which is the Rambam. You're quoting a rishon in the Rambam.
We'll see. We'll see.
What
we're going to see.
He says it's a stockless.
It's stockless.
By the way, the beginning of the Tshuva, Moshe goes very strong to prove that the chi of having a mechitza is deraisa. It's minat Torah. It's a very interesting thing. He says even though we learn it out from a pasuk in Zechariah, but just because we learn it from a pasuk in Zechariah, that's just where we learn out that it was our tradition to have this. But really, it didn't start then and there by that hesped. Therefore, he holds really certain things that we learn out from Divrei Kabbalah, from Divrei Nevi'im, in reality are derais. And he has all the rais different places in the Shas. We're not going to go into that whole pilpul. That's a lot of the pilpul until now was based on him starting off everything at the basic root. Is it derais? Is it the Rabbanan? Akabanim, even if it wasn't derais, it's still a chiv. It would be a chiv for the Nevi'im. But Ramosha held coolly, it's not
Torah.
What does
it mean?
No, there are chiyuv in the Torah, they're not part of the Tayyak mitzvahs, not so posh. It's a concept that we learn
about. Like the Lama Tesmach that has to be associated with something or not that?
No, there's concepts, there's Torah concepts, they're not part of the Tayyak mitzvahs. They're concepts that we find in the Torah.
So the over-light-test?
I'll tell you, there's a din, Eim Ma'arim Simcha B'Simcha. And that's just to mix one simple and another. You want it to marry of children, that's the marry of two in the same day, the same week. Now, what's the din of Eima Arvin Simcha V'Simcha? What do we learn out from? We learn it out from Lavan. What did Lavan do? Lavan married first, he gave Leah to Yaakov. And then when he said the next morning, he said, Lama Risani, why did you trick me? I want Rachel. He said, I'll give you Rachel. So he made it after he finished Sheva Brach. He said, Mala Shavua Zois, and I'll give you Rachel, but you have to work after the Chasen. Right? So Lamaisa, he waited. So we learn after the year the concept of Imar and Simcha Basimcha, a big Pella. It's before Matan Torah, it's something that Lavan did. But we learn out from there the din of Imar and Simcha Basimcha. So there's a lot of discussions in Lomdis, but not necessarily. We can learn out certain ideas and concepts from Torah, it doesn't mean that they're Tayag mitzvahs.
It's min Torah, but it's not, but it's a Darabonah.
It's a concept in a Torah, Lamal Shal Meiser. It's a Vayita Meiser, because this is all before Matan Torah. We don't have any psukim about Meiser, of a Meiser when it comes to money, produce later on the Torah. The only Meiser we have is Meiser Behemoth. Where do we have the Meiser, we give money, Meiser for money? Some say it's a attack only Midrabanan. Some say not even Midrabanan, it's a minig. However, others say, a third sheet that says it's Minat Torah. And there are many people that hold this Minat Torah. How could it be Minat Torah? Where's the Pasuk? By Avram Avinu. Avram Avinu gave Malki Tzedek Meiser. So what's Shad? And Yitzchak gave Meisers. This is before Matan Torah. So how can we say there's a Chiyuv? There was no Chiyuv.
It's learned out from Min HaTorah, but it's a Darabonah.
Some want to say it's called Minig, it's Minig, but it's such an ancient Minig. It starts from the Avos. It's a Minig, but it's a Minig, it's from the Avos.
But the Avos kept
the Torah.
The Avos kept the Torah. They did it. We say it's from the...
Okay.
Torah means it's derived from the Torah, if you say a Shem or whatever.
I don't want to really get into it. The reason why I skipped out the whole thing, because it's not Negea really, if it's from the Nevi'im, the Reis, so we know we have to anyways. It's interesting that Moshe... Ramosha's whole mahalik, how he builds it. Lamaisa on the page Sadik Ches on the top in the left column. The first paragraph, Hayoitzim is there, the fourth line of the page. Hayoitzim is there. Based on what I say, Gama Batan Yikasius, not only in the Beis HaMikdash, and not only you having a Hespid, not only by Sukha Beis HaSheva, but also in Yidavim, Skats and Shanoshim and Oshim, many men and women are coming together, the Svalos. So Yoyser Lasik Zustu the Shanoshim and Lamayla. Better to make a porch on top. Ramosha held, better than having side by side, on down on the same floor, better to have the porch. Because that's what the Mishnah calls a Tikkun Gadol. Better to have like a Dishul. If for some reason it's hard to make a balcony in the shul, you have to make a real mechitza on the floor. Hold back from kalas rosh, for lightheadedness. You can't apply the concepts of mechitza like be'erivin, hilchas Shabbos. I say, oh, I have a mechitza. It's 10 tefachim high. It's a good mechitza to enclose my driveway, my backyard, my bungalow. That's mechitzas bechlal in Torah. The kinds of mechitza when it comes to the inyan of a shul mechitza, it's a different mechitza. It's about kalos reish. It's not about whether this is considered a separate reshus, a separate area. I divided the space halachically. It's considered a separate domain. It's not about domains. It's about kalos reish. There's not enough going b'she'or and psuchim. You can have open gates. Let's say you have an open doorway. I'll have an open doorway. I'll have the men and the women in one place. And I have like a big entrance. A nice big entrance. So the men and women can be next to each other. More and more able to. He says, no. That's not a mechitza. So ain't a chanami. You're considered like you're in a separate room. A pi halacha. What is in one room? One is in the other. Women are in one room, one in another room. They're not in the same room, Pialocha. It's a separate domain, a separate reshus. However, when it comes to mechitza, dinah mechitza, the gabi shul, beis haknesses, you don't apply this concept. That's what happened to the beis hamikdash. Originally, the men were outside. The women were inside. Then the men were inside, the women were outside. Chazal said, that's not enough. So that's punk the same thing. They were in separate rooms, al-derech, separate rooms. And there was an opening in between. Still, though, there was a problem, makalas reish. So Chazal Dafke, the tikkun gadol that you have to have, is tikkun gadol having a zustra balcony. will gehen le sagi gam khit sha sort vor meiner karke shine klumme in kalasweish. It's not enough to have a mechitz of 10 tvachim high, which is very low. Maybe this table is 10 tvachim high. You can't have such a chain of klumli in kalas reish. You can't help for kalas reish. She choyl medaber laharbes besichem anashim. Everyone can talk and have conversation. The women believe shum kaishi. There's no issues. Really, with them there can be touching. The ain loch a kalas reish gedoyl mezum. And nechshu kibrova mamish is mamish considered like they're mingling. Va'asim ediraisa. She giruim imichitis dila ezas nashim lechel b'mikdash. She leilav shehoyse yoyse nikr. It was worse than what they originally separated in ezas nashim. And so last is mechitza gavoya b'mida kazu shaliyavol dekalasvish. Avol, mestamin is daiti, what is the actual shear? It can't be ten tvachim. But what's the shear? Shear mechitza? Should be over the shoulders. The whole thing in a mechitza is not for because of a staklos. Ramosha held the ian can't be because of seeing. You know why the issue can't be because of seeing? Because originally, how were they allowing it to be on the same floor? There was an issue of seeing on the first, right when they were on the same floor together. When the men were outside, the women inside. So obviously Chazal HaTchila did it, they weren't worried about Re'iyah. So must be the issue was mingling. Because the HaTchila had it Chazal allow them to set up on the same floor in separate rooms near each other. It's still a concept of Re'iyah. Shei Re'iyah, this is Ramesh's Hechrich. Hara'iyadu gam mitchila mikol mokim itilu lechoshel azeh. After Tikkun Gadol, your point that you mentioned, even after the Tikkun Gadol, he doesn't say anywhere that there was a mechitza on the balcony. The balcony was open. You're mechaven, right?
Yeah.
You have to wait till the end of this year, but you have to hear the opposing opinions also. A balcony, a porch, when the Torah calls gezustra, it doesn't mean it had a mechitza around, it was just a flat board.
Also,
I'm
sorry, it was at night. It's a bit different than by day.
There's no light.
They had
benoit
shalor.
Yeah, but it wasn't so...
Good, but that's not the chelki. But that's not the chelki. The ayin eidiv in da peizayin matoises. O repeatish mishal la ramba. The women were able to be seen. There was nothing around it. Actually, even though the men that were underneath the porch couldn't see on top, because they were balconies on top of them, how there were men in the middle. So there was no problem with the Riyah. By the way, this doesn't mean there's a heter for Riyah. You're not allowed to look at women for Hano. Even when a woman is fully dressed sneistic, there's no heter to look at a woman for deriving pleasure. For hana, that's aser. What we mean over here, that Chazal were at choishish, they weren't concerned about Re'iyah. That's a discussion. There's not a heter for Re'iyah, Chas
v'Shalom.
Lamaise, he has a big problem. The Pirush HaMishnah is al-Rambam, like we saw before, which is brought in the Tosis Yomtiv, with the Tshuvas Maram Shik Paskin that way. Clearly says that the issue is because of Re'iyah. So the Moshe goes on to say, here he gets a little bit stuck. Asha Rambam lepirushi lemishne sukkah sham kasa, the last paragraph in the left column, the shli stakla anashim anashim, ayin sham. It says clearly he shouldn't see. We can't learn it's because of seeing. That wasn't the issue. We have to be doichik, the spirit of Shemeshnayis. Again, he goes over his point. When they were up on top, they were able to be seen. There wasn't anything around. It doesn't say there was a mechitza.
He said it was a
nighttime. So the Moshe, the issue with the Moshe comes very strong with his point, and he has a lot of svaris, different svaris. But the ending, when it comes to dealing with the Pirush HaMishnayis, it gets very difficult. The Satmar Rav, the Divrei Yoel, has a big tshuva in his first chelik, which he writes very sharp. He doesn't understand this whole tshuva. The clear Pirush HaMishnayis, and a Moshe, because he has his own svaris, maybe they're good svaris, He first of all, he starts off, Rav Moshe, he himself writes, he writes Mekabedik, but he writes very strong. He himself says it's a deraisa. It's an issa deraisa. So we're dealing here with the issa min ha-Torah. I don't know if the Satmar of Be'etzim held that way, but Rav Moshe, you yourself hold it's an issa min ha-Torah. And here, we have a clear pirush of Mishnayis al-Rambam. It says clearly it's because of a staklus. And the Tosis Yomtov says that the Din Imoy, the Tosis writes, Yomtov writes on him. And here, Rav Moshe is coming with logic. Yes, Svaris, Shkoyach Svaris, but how is your Svaris going to go? And in Inyan Min HaTorah, you're going to start pushing around Svaris. You're playing with the Din Min HaTorah. He goes on the very, very long tshuva. And many, many other poiskim didn't hold. Rav Moshe, I want to point out a few things. Rav Moshe Shita, people misquoted. It's mamish, the most quoted. People think Rav Moshe held Eser Tvachim, 10 Tvachim, Mechitz is good. It's 100% false. I have not seen a tshuva for any Rav that was yet matter. You go into some very modern shuls,
which were matter.
And the Balabatim were matter. They put up a Mechitz like this. So Nishki Mechitza, that's for Gedoyim, that's for the goats, for the goats. So Nishki Mechitza. They say a joke, they say that the Moshe and the Satmar Rav one time met each other in a base oval. Now the halachi ain't nois in shalom base oval. You're not allowed to give shalom aleichem to someone in a base oval. So the Satmar Rav met the Moshe, so he stuck at his hand and he shalom shal aleichem to the Moshe. So the Moshe said, ain't nois in shalom base oval. So the Moshe said, Lefishi Toscha, the cheer over here is considered a good of mechitza, so we're not considered in a base oval. Zanishiyetz in a base oval. So I don't think I don't know if the mice b'chal happened. If the mice happened, it was a joke. The Moshe himself, the Satmar Rav was made with Derech
HaTzachas. The Moshe and Thea was so funny.
Moshe was not so nispal. Moshe had a lot of tshuvas. That he had a number of tshuvas that were very controversial, but he didn't back down. He wasn't so nispal. Yeah. Usually when people wrote back to the Moshe knocking his tshuvas, he didn't back down. It was very few times that the Moshe said he made a mistake. He would defend himself. But look, that kachi darka shel Torah. But the Maisa, what you said before, lo yira Moshe shita, as long as you have a mechitza, which the Moshe in other places clarifies 5 feet tall, even if it's see-through. But I want to mention, you know, even according to the Moshe later on says in the shul, we have to go to Maidiv. But the Moshe says, it's only in a shul, you have an issue where they don't dress sneas in a shul. If they don't dress sneas in a shul, the women don't come dress sneas. During davening, you have a problem of re'ias erva. Le'yire b'cha erva's dover, v'hoyim echanecha kodesh. In Allah, there's an issa min ha-Torah to say a bracha, to say Hashem's name, to daven, if women aren't dressed appropriately. So maybe you say if the women are in the back of the shul with such a mechitza, you know, but... So the Moshe constantly says it's only in a shul with a dressing tznistik.
Where does this whole thing apply with it?
Where does this whole thing... I think the only place where you can have the Moshe's mechitza is in Satmar. It's the only place you can make such a mechitza. And they dafke won't make the mechitza, so... You have a... It's an issue.
The Moshe
is... The Rebbe... I want to just... The most Peskim disagree with the Moshe. You know, Lamaisa shul that's out of town, and the shul that does it this way, they have a balcony without a proper mechitza on the balcony, or they have 5 feet tall mechitza. So they have Ramay Shashita. You can't make a machah because they don't belong to that archihila. They have, if they're going to go with, if they're following Ramay Shashita exactly the Ramay Shashita said it, they have someone to rely upon. But on the other hand, it wasn't accepted that way. And Rav Moshe's own shul on the Lower East Side didn't have such a mechitza. Rav Moshe was using this. Rav Moshe himself writes in this tshuva in the ending. He writes that Hamach Amachmirin lahagbiya mechitza shelo yisro gam rashi and tavolam bracha. Rav Moshe held that zikr. It's better to make it above the heads. Better to make it higher. But if you're dealing with a shul that's going to say that we're going to tear down the mechitza, we're going to sit separate. It's going to go conservative. You need a kula, so the Moshe held that me'ikr hadin, if you're going to look into the Yisayda Advarim. You know, we have a lot of things as a Masoyer and a Minig. In Europe, no one made mechitzas like Rav Moshe. No one ever said the Torah of Rav Moshe until Rav Moshe came in 1946 in Tal Shavav. It came out with the Chiddush. No one said it. I'm not coming to say that means it's wrong, the Chiddush, but The point is that there is a certain Masorah and a Minig, the way Klal Yisrael. Now, when you need a Heter, you have a chance at Chak, you have a Heter. So Amal HaPoisik comes and says, even though our Minig is this way, but I look up for a Heter, a chance at Chak situation, we'll look up to find a Heter, see what is there any Heter. So the Moshe, that was his derech over here. His shul wasn't like that. He definitely held it wasn't the best thing.
It's like the Chol
HaSnam. Yeah, like the Chol HaSnam. You have to. You have a problem. You have a situation.
Twice in the tshuva.
But the what? But the point is a machloikis in halacha. In halacha, it's a machloikis. The Moshe held that api halacha, you don't have to make it higher. Just a machmir tavle bracha to make it higher. La halacha. But it doesn't mean that Moshe said that this is what you should do, and that was the minig always. When you have a situation where people don't want to have a mechitza, so yes, a mechitza in a chanami. I want to point out, the Rebbe was very makbid, and the Rebbe was not makabal at all the shita of Moshe. He always stressed that it has to be in an oifen, shalayiru, you can't see. So therefore, even when you make a balcony, it had to be with a tinted glass. Like you have in 770, they have a very dark tinted glass. They say a story that it was when they were making renovation 770 in the Tashin Lamed in the early 70s, and Erev Rosh Hashanah, it was they mamish finishing up the balcony, and they put up a glass, but it was tinted, but it wasn't tinted well. They said the Rebbe said he's not coming down to the shul to daven Rosh Hashanah or daven in his room if they don't fix it up properly. But the Maisa, that's a Shmua. But the Maisa is, we have many letters of the Rebbe. The next two pages, the Rebbe says clearly, he writes clearly, I'll show you just some Lashonis over here. Let's look at this, the last page in the Kuntris. The Rebbe writes on the top of the page, L'kosim negei l'mechitza shechelka elyin mischucha shkufa. You write that the upper part of the mechitza is glass, see-through glass. It's me, Choy Shem Lanamis, but the Rebbe wrote this letter. Who do you think you're fooling over here? It's a see-through. The next one, the Rebbe's letter. You want to make a mechitza, Sheina Zakil, and Bitim is Nashim, that from the women's side they could see through. It's from the men's side it's tinted, they can't see through clearly. They could see through, but it's not clear. So the Rebbe, it's not clear exactly how not see-through it was. What are you looking dafke to find to push yourself into a heter? Well, what do you need it for? Besides for this whole heter of trying to rely is a doiche gadol. But what are you looking for this heter? The person wanted to say, oh, look in 770, they have a balcony. He said, the Ezes Noshim over there, you want to make on the same floor. And you want to make a glass which is tinted. Over here we have Sai, a balcony, it's all the way up, and Sai it's tinted. You want to make on the same floor tinted. Zaisloy. In the bottom over here they bring from a letter that the Rebbe said, they asked the Rebbe, what's the shear? L'chol hapachis 6 feet. L'chol hapachis 6 feet. The other place he wrote, L'mayla mikoymas ish. Now Moshe wrote 5 feet because he held five feet because it had to do with Taruva's mingling. So it's people are not going to be able to have conversation. The Satmarov writes, the Kalas Reish, he says the head is the Iker Mokum in the Kalas Reish, he writes. Has like a Shmakalashim. He said the Reish itself, that's the Mokum in the Kalas Reish. He said that when you're having your conversations, your mouth, your eyes, it's all in the head. So what do you want to do? You're making with the head. Good, but our Moshe already felt it's already a very uncomfortable conversation over here. It's not, you're not going to have any handshakes, not going to be any gear, so this was enough for that. So, Akaponim, we have to know, we have to not allow any. Maybe next year we mamshe to talk about Mechitza by Chasana, by Sheva Brochis, Mechitza by Drosha. For other things, we'll talk about the Makoridis for those in the Anabalina at the next level. Should we keep these? Okay, we can keep it.
People not in teacher
in general. Except for the general.
You have to bring it up.
The men and women.
They're not dafka, they are dafka.
The Rebbe's household is all Lubavitcher Rebbe, and they also did it that way.
This is a separate room.
By the Rebbe's Seder, the women were in a separate room. The women were not by the table. The Rebbe's sons were not by the table.
Yeah.
They sat in the head of the kitchen, their Seder, and they would stand by the door to hear a Kiddush, whatever it was, and they had their own Seder. Listen, you know, this room for Kula went just family.
I'm glad you gave
just a family, just a few people. You're making a very big event.